I think the sheet of ice has always represented an innocence in the game of hockey. Something that doesn't have an age, doesn't have a demographic, doesn't have a skin color. It's something that we all have experienced, all those who love the game of hockey. I think people assume that when you think of the game of hockey, it's always had its origins in the white space for white people. And I think when it comes to history, I think a lot of people would be surprised at the contributions of people of color, especially here in Canada. It's important that this league and this story get recognized because it's a part of our history. And if we are fans of the game of hockey, we are fans of where the game has come from. To know where you come from is to know where you're going, and that's why this story is important to be told. The story of the Colored Hockey League takes place in Nova Scotia, 1895. Back in the 1800s, the game of hockey, at least when it comes to organized teams, was predominantly white. Again, we're looking at a time when there were segregation, and for the white community, hockey was the game that they played. And in the black community, hockey was a game that people observed, people tried, but never had the opportunity to play on the white teams because of the times we were living in. James Kenney, James Ark Johnson, and Pastor James Borden decided that they wanted to bring in more young black men into their church. And what they decided to do was offer them a chance of a lifetime. Be a part of our church congregation, and we will form a hockey team. So what they did was they formed their first teams, and they were part of the church. You had teams like the Amherst Royals, Halifax Eurekas, also the Africville Seasides. They brought all the black men and women together for them to be able to organize and strategize on how to put these teams together, how to put these games together, and how to make these events very special. There was a lot of flash and a lot of creation and a lot of creativity in the league. So for example, in the white leagues, the goalies stood erect and they stayed that way, and that was their rule. But in the Colored Hockey League of the Maritimes, their goaltenders were allowed to flip-flop and go down on the ice and save the pucks any which way they could. Eddie Martin, he was a baseball player, decided, why don't I swing my hockey stick the exact same way, but downwards? Now in the newspapers, they called that the baseball shot, but we all know this as the slap shot. Spectators were able to see a lot of innovations that are things that we see to this day in the game of hockey. It was a league that was incredible, that went on from 1895 to around 1930, and it's just a shame that it had to come to an end. I was thinking about the legacy of the Colored Hockey League of the Maritimes, and to me, it's more about its presence. I think the fact that it was there, I think the fact that this league was around in the late 1800s and survived many years and add to the game of hockey will always be something that we should always be proud of. The Colored Hockey League's history is very important to me personally because I'm a proud Canadian. Grew up here all my life as a black man, loving this game of hockey that sometimes hasn't been as inclusive as I wanted it to be. But being able to share the history of the Colored Hockey League allows me to say that we are just as important to the game of hockey as anybody else. It's a beautiful game, and there's a lot of great contributions, and the Colored Hockey League is one of them. That's what makes me the most proud.